इंट्रोडक्षन्स टू वेदांत टेक्स्ट बै श्री श्री सच्चिदानंदेन्द्र सरस्वती स्वामीजी होळे नरसीपुर. इन दिस लेक्चर सीरीज वी हैव सीन ऑलरेडी 20 सेशन्स. टुडे इज दि 21st सेशन. ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरिः ओम. श्री गणेशाय नमः. डॉक्टर कृष्णमूर्ति शास्त्री दंबे पुणच ಬಂಟ್ವಾಳ ತಾಲೂಕು ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಕನ್ನಡ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಭಾರತ. ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದ್ವೈತಿಕ್ ಎಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟಿಸಮ್ ಆಂಟೀರಿಯರ್ ಟು ಗೌಡಪಾದ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟಾಪಿಕ್. ವಿ ಶಲ್ ನೌ ಟರ್ನ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್. ಈಸ್ ಗೌಡಪಾದ ಪರ್ಸನಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಸಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ರಿವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಔಪನಿಷದ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನ್, ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಹೀ ಎನಿ ಪ್ರಿಡಿಸೆಸರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಹೂಸ್ ವ್ಯೂಸ್ ಹೀ ವಾಸ್ ಪರ್ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸಿಸ್ಟಮೆಟೈಸ್. Professor Murthy quite admits the possibility of this alternative when he says Shankara's reference to Gaudapada as one knowing the tradition, Sampradaya Veda, may mean that there was an Advaitic school of Vedanta too, although it might not have been a dominant one. Indeed, as the professor adds in a footnote on the same page, indications are not wanting that Gaudapada himself may be appealing to older teachers of his own tradition when he uses expressions like Vedanteshu Vichakshanaihi मुनिभिर्वेदपारगैहि एटसेट्रा. बट देर इज नो नेसेसिटी टू बी सैटिस्फाइड विद द मियर गेसेस, फॉर वी हैव पॉजिटिव एविडेंस टू दिस इफेक्ट इन शंकरास राइटिंग्स. इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस हिस फ्रीक्वेंट रेफरेंस टू संप्रदाय ट्रेडिशन इन हिस भाष्यास ईज इन इट्स सेल्फ इंप्रेसिव. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन हिस रेफरेंसेस टू गौड़पाद एस ए संप्रदाय विद. इन हिस गीता भाष्य वी हैव पैसेजेस टू कन्विंस अस एज टू हाउ मच स्टोर he sets by a good tradition. This one is in reference to an opponent who holds that the individual soul is ultimately merged in Brahman through meditation based upon a knowledge of the distinction of Kshetra and Kshetrajna, the material world and Ishwara respectively. The fool of a Pandit who hopes to reconcile the doctrine of samsara and liberty with the Shastra in this way is really a suicide. Being self-deluded, he deludes others as well. Because for want of the right tradition, he abandons the express teaching of the Shruti and offers an imaginary construction of his own. Hence, being bereft of the tradition, he must be ignored like a fool, albeit he may happen to be versed in all Shastras. Evam manvano yassa pandita pasadaha संसार मोक्षयोः शास्त्रस्य च अर्थवत्त्वं करोमि इति आत्मः स्वयं मूढो अन्यांश्च व्योम व्यामोहयति. शास्त्रार्थ संप्रदाय रहितत्वात् श्रुतहानिम् अश्रुतकल्पनाञ्च कुर्वन् तस्माद् असंप्रदायवित् सर्वशास्त्रविदपि मूर्खवत् एव उपेक्षणीयः. एंड गीता भाष्य 13:2 शंकर भाष्य. And this passage is an answer to those who that think it difficult or impossible to get a knowledge of the self owing to its being formless. True, it is so far those who have not been properly initiated by a teacher knowing the right tradition, for those who have not properly listened to Vedantic teachings, for those whose mind is quite engrossed in the external objects of sense, and for those who are untrained in its use of the valid means of knowledge. Satyamevam guru sampradaya rahitanam ashruta vedantanam atyanta bahir vishaya asakta buddhinam samyak pramaneshu akrata shramanam. Gita Bhashya 1850. Here are some direct references bearing testimony to the existence of a tradition of absolutism before Shankara and presumably Gaudapada. In Gita Bhashya, Shankara introduces us to a shloka 13:13 in these words. Even the illusory form due to upadhis is treated as though it were a property of Brahman, the knowable, just for the sake of rendering its existence conceivable. Hence the statement that it is with hands and feet everywhere. Accordingly, the knowers of the right tradition say, reality devoid of all manifoldness is explained through deliberate superimposition of attributes and subsequent negation or rescission. Tata hi sampradaya vidam vachanam adhyaropa apavadabhyam nishprapancham prapanchate iti. Again in the Mandukya Bhashya, While concluding a discussion on the function of the Shastra as a means of knowledge of Atman, Shankara quotes the Sutra of the Knowers of Agama. Siddhanto Nivartakatvadityagama Vidam Sutram. Siddhanto Nivartakatvat Iti Agama Vidam Sutram. The validity of the Shastra is established just because it negates properties not pertaining to the self-evident Atman. Gaudapadakarika Bhashya 232. Once more, in the Brihadaranyaka Bhashya, Shankara appeals to his tradition in support of his interpretation of texts treating of creation. Atra cha sampradaya vidaha akhyayikam achakshate. And here, the knowers of the right tradition narrate a story in illustration of this truth. We learn from the glossate Anandagiri that these are references to a certain Dravidacharya, who according to the glossate again wrote an extensive commentary on the Chandogya Upanishad also. From another source we learn about one more teacher of this school, Vakyakara Brahmanandin. In his commentary on the 217th verse of the third chapter of Sarvajnatma's Sankshepa Sharirika, Madhusudana Saraswati gives an extract from that ancient thinker with prefatory remarks of his own, well worth quoting in extenso. Chandogya Vakyakarena Brahmanandinapi Purvapakshe Asatah Satascha Utpattau Doshamuktva Samvyavaharikam व्यावहारिक मायामयत्वे मायामयत्व पक्षेण समाधानमुक्तं नासतः उत्पत्तिः अनिष्पाद्यत्वात् नापि सतः प्रवृत्त्यानर्थक्यात् सत्व अविशेषात् अभिव्यक्त्यर्थम् इति चेत् न तस्याः अपि सत्वात् प्रवृत्ति नित्यत्वाच्च सदाभिव्यक्ति प्रसंगः न संव्यवहार मात्रत्वात् इति. इट इज वर्दी ऑफ नोट दैट हियर द पूर्वपक्षिन इज मेड टू एम्फसाइज द इम्पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ द ओरिजिनेशन आइदर ऑफ द एग्जिस्टेंट और द ऑफ द नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट विच डायलेमा ब्रह्मदंडिन ब्रह्मानंदिन अवॉइड्स बाय टेकिंग ऑल बर्थ एज संव्यवहार मात्र कन्वेंशनल ओनली और इन Gaudapada's words, Mayaya, Janma, Illusory Birth. Last but not the least in importance are the three shlokas quoted at the end of Shankara's Bhashya on the fourth Brahma Sutra, Tattva Samanvayat. They are quoted to support the doctrines of one, Mithyatma, Illusory Self. Second, Bodhe Karyam Katham Bhavet, the incompatibility of the karma with the Brahma knowledge. Third one, anvishtasyat pramataiva papmadoshadivarjitah. The identity of the seeker after knowledge with Brahman as soon as Brahman is realized. Fourth, pramanam tu atmanishchayat. The limitation of the pramanas to the empirical life and their sublation by knowledge of the Supreme Self. Tenets of vital importance to Advaita Vedanta of the type that Gaudapada and Shankara commend. The question may be now considered as well. Nay settled, I think. It is not merely probable, but absolutely certain that Shankara and Gaudapada did have a tradition of Advaitic teachers who had been contending to hold their own against the other monistic schools who were all busy struggling to establish that their school had the sole right to represent the original Upanishadic teaching. Mutual influence of the Advaita and the Madhyamika systems was not impossible during those times, though we have no means of ascertaining to what extent this took place in fact. Professor Murthy's remarks in this connection are very significant. Influence is not necessarily acceptance or borrowing of the doctrines. That too is influence which stimulates the systems to modify, revise or even to reaffirm their doctrines. Influence may be expressed as much through opposition as by acceptance. The development of their system may be as much due to reaction upon the other as to its inherent capacity to march on. Perhaps Gaudapada's work represents the last phase of this kind of reaction on the Vedantic side. We must be therefore cautious, I think, in our pronouncements in such matters, even if we actually find witnesses on either side accusing the other of serious plagiarism. Next topic, Gaudapada's alleged borrowing from Mahayana works. Let us see in the next session. So this ends 21st session in Introductions to Vedanta, text by Sri Sri Sachidanandendra Saraswati Swamiji. Salutes to his holy souls or feet. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu, om tat sat.